Today I will repair this BMW air compressor. This is a part of the rear axle air suspension, also known as the self-leveling suspension, that ensures the correct vehicle height in any condition. This type of air compressor is found on most of the BMW's models, the 5, 7 and X series. The air compressor will fail most of the cases after one of the air springs will fail. The air compressor is the air supply for this system and is driven by an electric motor. This is composed of the electric motor, of course, the air dryer, discharge valve with pressure limitation at maximum 13.5 bars, any pressure over this will be automatically discharged back into the atmosphere, and the solenoid valve block with two solenoid valves for left and right air springs. This system is composed of two level sensors, one for each wheel, the rear wheels, control unit, air compressor and two air springs for left and right rear wheels. When the car is loaded, the sensors will see this difference. The control unit will command the air compressor to charge the air springs and the car will return to its normal level. When the car is unloaded, the level of the car will be different, the car will be higher. The control unit will command the solenoid valves and the discharge valve to open to release the air from the air springs and to return the car to its normal level. The normal operation process of this system is very smart and interesting. The electric motor will move a piston. The piston will compress the air. The air from the atmosphere has some humidity and the humidity is not good for this system. So the air dryer will remove the humidity from the air and will send dry air to this discharge valve and to the solenoid valve block for the air springs. When the air springs will need to be discharged, the solenoid valve will release the air back into the air dryer. The dry air will take the humidity from the dryer and will release it back into the atmosphere to this discharge valve. When this system is failing, when one air spring will fail, this process will be interrupted. And when this process is interrupted, the air dryer will become full of water because the air compressor will send dry air over and over again to inflate that air spring. So no more dry air will be returning to this system to take out the humidity from the dryer. And the humidity from this air dryer will become water and the water will destroy my discharge valve and solenoids. From my own experience working with this system, most of the cases, the discharge valve will fail. After that, I have seen the solenoid block valve will fail. Next on the list is the rings from the piston will fail. And very rarely, I have seen electric motors that have failed. Now I need to completely disassemble the system and find the problem. First step, I will make a short test. I will need two pins. This is the plug for the electric motor. Here I have a 12 volts battery connected, plus and minus. And the electric motor, it's very quiet, that is good. But you can hear the air is discharged. Okay, so at this moment I think the discharge valve have a problem. With a 12 millimeter wrench I will remove this air duct. And so. Next step with T30 I will remove these two screws. Now I'm able to remove this part. And from what I see, the ring of the piston is in good condition, is not broken. That is a good sign. Okay. Next step with T25, I will remove the discharge valve. This is the discharge valve. So you can see this discharge valve is not looking too good, too well. With this hose, I'll connect it here. And on this end, I will blow. And you probably can hear the air is escaping because this solenoid valve is stuck open. Okay, next step, I will open the air dryer. This have two T30 screws. I need to be very careful because inside here it's a spring that is loaded. You can see the spring. And you can clearly see the water. This here is a air dryer. This is a plate. Yeah, it's full of water. I need to dry this air dryer. Okay, for the moment I will put this aside. And you can see here different electric motors with different problems. This one have a broken rod. This one have a broken ring. This one is good. You can see this one is broken. This ring is broken. And this one is in very good condition. It's not broken. The solenoid valve is destroyed by water. Here I have another one that I have opened it. And you can see here, this is the inside piston that will push against this plastic head from here. And with this ring from here, we'll close, we'll make a perfect seal and won't let air to pass. But the problem, the water will enter inside here and will destroy this valve. And most of the times, this piston will remain stuck open, will remain in the down position, and the air will pass like this one. And you can see here the water damage, the rust. Next step, I will check these valves. These valves have two screws, T25. To remove the hose, I need to push this ring inside and the hose will be released. And now, to access the valves, I need to remove these four screws. They are with T20. Okay, after removing the screws, I can open the valves and these are the valves that will fail. To test this the same with the hose, I will try to blow, but this one is good, it's closed, and this one is also in good condition. I will test them on open position. I will slide them back here. I will set my power supply to 13 volts, 12 volts. like the valve. This one is good. This one is in perfect condition, and this one the same. And this one is in good condition also. I'll remove all the O-rings. I will clean everything. I will grease all the O-rings. Okay. And I will put back the screws. Next step is to dry the filter. For this I will use a hot air gun. You can see when they are dry, they have different color. And now you can see they are perfectly dry. Next step is to dry this. Okay, next step I need to remove this filter. Because this is wet. You can see how wet it is. And this one is perfectly dry. Last step, I will remove these three screws because here I have a sponge and I want to make sure that the sponge is not wet. And the sponge is perfectly dry. I will put it back. Okay, now I will put back the filter. Perfect. Now I will transfer the bolts in this glass. Now I will pour the bolts inside the filter. Okay, the filter is almost ready. Next step, I will clean the head and I will dry it because I have some water. I will remove this valve with T15. With some paper towels and old good friend. Now I need to clean the head here. Inside here it's perfect. Okay, after cleaning everything, last step is to clean the spring and now I can reassemble the filter with the head. Now I will clean this mechanic valve. Like so. I will use a little bit WD-40. Perfect. For this compressor, I have a brand new discharge valve. On this, I will use the old O-rings from the old one. Step. Click, click. Okay, everything is perfect. I'll put back the valves. And finally, this compressor is repaired. Now I'm able to make a test. I use these two pins in the plug for the electric motor. Here is very simple. The red one is plus, the brown one is minus. Plus it's this one from here, and minus is this one. You can hear the different sound. Now this air compressor is under pressure. I will release this discharge valve. You can hear it. Now it's without pressure. This here is the intake, you can see. This air compressor is repaired and ready to go back on the car. I hope you learned something in this video. If you like it, show me by hitting the like button. If you are still here, that means that you are like this video or you are in desperate need to know how to repair this type of air compressor. But other way, thank you for watching these videos. Thank you for being with me. Until next time, you know the drill. Stay awesome. Bye now.